everybody. It's Table for Two Show. You be the judge. Well, welcome to another episode of You Be the Judge. We have found yet another Kickstarter game that we support. Mm-hmm. Again, we support it, otherwise it wouldn't be on the show. This game is actually called Darkrock Ventures. Sounds kind of scary.
Yeah.
But it's by, it's by Magic Meeple Games, and it also shows Gamelin Games. But the guy from Magic Meeple, Ian, is the one who gave us the game to let us borrow it to try it. And we also tried it, or he showed it to us when we were at Origins this year. He's a very nice man, sat down with us, showed us the whole game. We really loved it. Well, can we put this on the show?
Yeah.
So you know if we ask for it to be on the show, then you know it's a good game. Philip is going to explain a little bit about the game, and then we're going to actually go right into it and play it so you can see a couple of rounds of how it's played, and then you be the judge, and we're hoping you'll back it because it really is a good game.
Okay.
Oh, P.S. This is a prototype. Let's make sure we stress that. It's a little bit of a small board.
Yep, small board. You might see a couple inconsistencies. It's okay. It's a prototype.
It's a prototype.
And it's all here.
But it's still cool.
Yeah.
Hi, Hank. Go ahead.
Okay, so this game, we're in space, and it's all about mining an asteroid to make money. Word ventures. It's about money. We each have a crew. We start out with three crew members. Mm-hmm. We also we have the ability to hire additional crew. We can hire one more crew member and one captain, so we can have up to five. Mm-hmm. We've got money on a track out here where we start with $2.
Just $2.
And what we're doing is we're trying to mine this asteroid for platinum, which is worth the most, cobalt, which is kind of in the middle, and iron, which is the cheapest but the easiest to get. We also have a couple other ways to get money. There's a solar array where we can collect energy.
Solar energy!
And we can just sell raw energy.
Very green.
And there's also something over here called neutronium, which there are a couple uses for that. It's not worth much, but it's pretty useful. Mm-hmm. And then we each have something called a rig die. We start out with one per crew, but we can earn additional rig die as we get $10 or $20. We can earn two more rig die each.
And also, by the way, we're playing it two-player, but this can actually play up to five players.
Yeah.
As you can see, all the pretty colored die. So bring your friends. But with two players, it works just as easily.
It works very well with two players, all the way up through five. So really enjoy that it does that. So, you know what? The rules are kind of thick, but they're not complex.
No.
It's just that there are a lot of different options you have in the game. And instead of us explaining all the options first, it'll just be confusing. I think it's just easier for us to jump in and start playing the game. We'll explain it as we go.
Absolutely.
So
who goes first?
We rolled.
We did roll.
We didn't just thumb wrestle or just yell who's going first. And Jane ended up with the leader card because she's going first.
Yeah. Leader card's nice, by the way. It tells you exactly how to play the game. So if you know how to play it, and you just want a quick guide, this is great. I like the leader card. And you can by the way, there's actually a spot on the board you can steal the leader card away from somebody. You might say, well, what's the good thing about being a leader? You get to place your crew first and things like that. So you get a better selection.
Little advantage.
Yeah.
Yep.
All right, so there's five steps to each round. Very simple steps, easy enough. The first couple might sound a little weird, and you'll be like, what's the point of those? But you'll see very quickly why. The first step is to roll what's called the white power dice. Okay, so I'm gonna roll them. You take those two die and you put them right in the middle of the board. Now, if for any reason they came up the same, or doubles as we say, you have to re-roll one to make them two separate dice.
Yeah,
they cannot be two
right.
the same number. Okay, so now we have a six and we have a four there. And that's pretty important. You'll see why in just a minute. The second thing of the round is you assign your crew members to different points on the board, and we take turns doing that. And again, we both have three members.
Starting with the leader.
Starting with the leader. So you'll see on the board, on each of the different areas, like you said, cobalt and platinum, there's numbers next to it, 6, 4, 2, 12, 10, and basically you're choosing which crew member should go on which mineral you want to hopefully mine. Or, if you don't want to mine minerals, or you want to use a crew member to do something else, you can attack the solar energy area, which I'll show you. And or neutronium, you can't really place yourself. You get those as a booby prize. We'll explain that in a little while. But then there's different parts of the board you can also do things on, different activity, different gear you can get. And you'll see, it'll hopefully make sense as you play. So the first thing I'm going to do, though, I am going to mine. Now, when you look at this, we have a six and we have a four. You're going to be combining one of these die with your rig die, your whatever color you have, red or in my case purple. So you got to be careful with this. So if I see a 6 and a 4, I might go with a 10 thinking I could probably get a 10.
Some pretty high numbers.
Yeah. So you go ahead and choose next.
Okay, so I'm going to put one of my crew members on. I'm going all the way up. I'm going to try for the 12.
Ooh.
It's harder to get, but it's worthwhile.
Okay, I'm going to actually put mine on the solar energy array, and here's why. Right now for this one, I get nothing on this turn. But if I want, I can leave it, and every turn I can move it up, and then eventually I can choose when I want to stop being on the array, and I take that many solar energy, which also gives you money, and you can sell them. But I'm going to start at the base.
Okay, and I'm going to go with the 8.
Oh, okay.
It's a little easier.
And I'm going to do something a little different. I'm going to put my last crew member on the cargo unlock. Now, you get 6 cargo places on your card to place the minerals and stuff, but you only get 3 to start with. 3 are locked, 3 are open. Mm-hmm. So by putting my meeple, on there, I can choose to unlock one of the spaces. There's also another one where you can unlock 2, but then you have to pay $1 to do that. So I'm just going to unlock 1 for now.
Okay, and then I'm going to do something really simple. Under crew, I'm going to do something called subcontract, where all I do is get $1 for a for just a regular crew member.
And that's step number 2 of the round.
Mm-hmm.
The third step is to roll the neutronium die.
Yeah.
It's basically it's another die. And then you put that one also in the middle. Now you might say, okay, what's the difference? There really is no difference. It acts just like the 2 white die, and you'll see we do those in a minute.
Mm-hmm.
The big difference is neutronium die can be re-rolled if you spend a neutronium, if you have a neutronium. It's a nice thing to have. It's like a little bonus to be able to re-roll the black die, but not the white die. So that's what that's all about.
Yeah.
Now, there's normally a fourth piece or fourth turn where you then turn over a bad guy or gal or whatever they are. Bad people. They're called the Therion Marauders.
Therion Marauders.
Marauders. Duh,
yes.
Okay, Therion Marauders. They're bad people. But you're not allowed to turn these cards over and start bad people's trouble until at least something has been exported or sold.
Mm-hmm.
So until something's been exported or sold, you don't use the bad guys. So,
right.
So far, so good. Last but not least, we resolve our crew. So starting with the leader, that's me.
Yes.
You resolve your crew. So now resolve. So I'm going to look at mine, and the first thing I do is I roll my rig die. I got a 6. Darn it, I should have played the 12. But that's okay.
You got my number.
It's okay. I have a 6, hence plus the 4, and you can only use your die 1 at a time.
Right.
I have the 10. So that's a good thing. So because I was able to resolve the 10, I take a mineral, cobalt.
That's the cobalt.
Off of there, and I get that mineral. Then I go on to my next thing, which I'm going to go and unlock my cargo, which means I can unlock 1 cargo. So now I have 4 cargo spaces. You can put 1 mineral in each cargo, just so you know. And I'm going to move up my solar array up to the number 1 spot, and I'm going to leave it there till the next turn. Eventually, I can choose when I want to take it off and take some solar.
Yeah, and what you'll notice is that we, when we're placing our characters or our crew members, we take turns, but resolving, she resolves, she's the leader, then I resolve. You can resolve in any order you want, but we don't take turns between each one.
Right.
So I'm going to roll my die.
Yep.
And I got a 2. Let's see. Well, with a 2 and a 6, I can get the 8.
Okay.
So I'll do that.
Oh, we should probably mention, these are all supposed to be orange.
It's one of those inconsistencies.
And because, they gave us 2 pink just to fill in, but...
Yeah, 2 were missing.
So you take the pink.
The 12, I'm kind of stuck because I can't use both of these. I have to, and I can't use that die over.
So you don't
anyway.
Get anything for that one.
So that goes back, and then for here, I just get $1.
Because you subcontracted out, it was helpful, helping somebody else somewhere
put
in the world.
That over here, and that's the end of my turn.
Yeah, and that's the dollar track. So as you're tracking along your money, eventually whoever has the most money wins. Oh, by the way, how does this game end? It's a good question. Three of the different areas of the asteroid, right, have to be emptied out.
Mm-hmm.
So once 3 of these are completely depleted, you finish out that round you're on, and then play 1 additional round, and then you're done, and whoever has the most money wins.
Yes.
Yeah. Okay, so that is the end of round 1, for a better word. So we're going to go ahead and continue on. So I'm going to go ahead and take these dice off the board.
Mm-hmm.
We got all our crew members back, and we'll start all over.
Except the solar array, that one.
Right, that one sticks. I'm going to go ahead and roll for the... Okay, we got a 6 and a 3 going on now. All right. Second thing is we're going to go ahead and assign. So, of course, my guy just stays there.
Mm-hmm.
I'm actually going to... Because I want to show this. I'm going to go to the export. And now you can export either 1 item, 2 items, or 3 items. I'm going to go right in the middle and say I'm going to try to export 2. Now, you can do up to 2, just so you know. So, if I only have 1, then that's fine.
Mm-hmm.
Your turn.
I'm going to take one of my crew, and I'm going for 12 again.
Okay. Oh, by the way, you cannot be on the same space as another person, but you can put two of your own crew members on the same space.
Right.
So you can do the same thing twice if you wanted to. Well, let's see. So we have a 6 and we have a 3. Ooh, I don't know. I'm going to go with the 6. See what we can do there.
I'm going to go with the 10.
Right. And, of course, my guy's still on there, so you go again.
And now I'm going to go with one of the gear over here, and I'm going to try rough imaging. Rough imaging will let me add or subtract 3 from my die as I'm trying to acquire something.
Okay, I'm going to roll the neutronium die. Mm-hmm. It's a 2. Mm-hmm. All right, so we're good there. Okay. So far, again, nobody has sold anything or exported, so we don't pick any bad guys for the 4th piece. But the 5th piece is now we do our resolve. So I'm going to resolve him by moving him up 1 more. Mm-hmm. I'm going to go for another. I'm going to resolve him, and first I'm going to roll my rig die, which didn't affect this at all, but 6. Oh, look, 6, 7, 8. No, I don't want 6, 7, 8. I want 6. Darn it. Oh, well.
Yeah.
So this does not get resolved. Wah, wah. Nope. So I put him here. Now, if you don't resolve any minerals during your turn, that's where the booby prize comes in. We call it, it doesn't say that in the book, by the way. You get 1 neutronium for not getting any minerals on your turns. That's a good thing, so you still get something, basically. Now, my last thing I'm going to resolve is I'm going to sell 2. Look at that. So I have 2 to sell.
That worked out.
That worked out really well. So I'm going to sell a blue and a red. Now, the red, because neutronium is ever so abundant, goes back into the pile. Mm-hmm. The blue just goes away. It doesn't ever get replenished.
It's gone.
And it tells me I get $6 for the blue and $1 for the red, hence $7 for me. Mm-hmm. And I move my token up. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. So I'm at $9 now.
You almost unlock the next
die. If I get to 10 and eventually 20, you get to have more rig die, which is kind of cool. All right.
Okay, so now I'm going to resolve.
Your turn.
And I rolled a 1.
That sucks.
Which is not good for my 12.
No.
So with the gear, I could add +3, but 1, 7, 10, I'm
not
still short.
Gonna do it.
10's good for this one, though. So I will at least get the cobalt.
Okay.
So I'll take the cobalt, but the 12, I get nothing. And I don't get the booby prize, the neutronium, because I actually did get something. And that's all I can
back.
Do. Yep.
Right, so that's the end of that round. See, easy.
Yeah, it starts to go pretty fast.
But you have to think, because you're trying to not only collect the minerals, you're trying to sell the minerals, and you want to make money, right? So let's go a couple more times.
Yep.
So I'm going to go ahead and roll the power dice. 6 and a 2.
Mm-hmm.
I'm going to leave him there. Oh, I have to leave him there. He's still there. So I'm going to go ahead and sign my 1 crew member. Let's see. So 6 and a 2. I'm going to try for the 10.
You're feeling gutsy.
Why not?
Let's see. I'm going for the 12 again.
All right. And I'm going to actually buy a crew member when it comes to resolve, because I want another crew member to play with.
Okay. And I'm not feeling real confident with the 12, so I'm going to go with that gear one more time.
Okay, and then, of course, I already have one on the board, so you get to place your last one.
And this one, I'm going to try something a little different. I'm going to try something called a rover.
Okay, we'll explain that when
another
comes time to the turn.
Yeah.
All right, so we're all placed. Mm-hmm. Go ahead and roll the neutronium die. Well, it's a 1. Very cute. All right. Now, because I exported last turn, we now get a bad guy.
Yeah.
Marauder. Blah, blah, blah. Basically what this means, and I can't see that far away, is whoever's on one of the imaging spaces. Oh, Phil, you're on one of the imaging spaces.
Yes.
So what this card looks at is it says, okay, this space is under attack.
Yeah, it's called the gear sabotage.
So
I'm on 2 of them,
Phil can do one of 2 things. He can flee, which means he just takes his piece and puts it back on his ship. You know, bye-bye.
Mm-hmm.
Or he can pay 1 mineral to save himself.
Yes. So, actually, I'm only on one of the imaging ones. I could pay 1 mineral. I'll pay the mineral. That's
right.
Easy. I'll get rid of the iron. That's the cheapest one.
Bye-bye iron.
And that's just gone.
Yep. All right. So that's been resolved, basically. So nothing too bad happened.
Nope. Not too bad. Put that over here.
All right. So, last but not least, we go ahead and we do our resolve.
Mm-hmm.
So I'm going to roll my rig die. I got a 5. Okay, first things first, I'm going to move this up one more space.
Yep.
Okay. I am going, so I have 5 plus, no 10 for me. All right, so he does not resolve.
Poo is the official space term.
He does not resolve, but I don't get any minerals, so guess what I get? I get a neutronium.
Okay.
But I'm also deciding I'm going to spend Well, I could spend either $3 to get one crew member or $5 to get my captain. I'm actually going to choose $5. One, two, three, four, five. And I'm going to activate my captain. Now, what's the big deal about the captain? Well, when you place him on an area, he gets to do two people were on there. So you get to do it twice, whatever it is. Well, so if I get there, I'll show you. Right now, I would say I've activated my captain.
And he's taller.
And he's a little taller. A little bit bigger. and that's it for my resolve.
Okay. Let's see. I've got... this isn't working out good for my 12 that I'm going for here. But let's see. So I also have something called a rover. Now, a rover is going to let me, if I do that first, move this guy from left or right by one position. So I could actually move him down to the two. Mm-hmm. That actually makes a lot of sense. Okay. I'm going to move him down to the two. And I don't need my rough imaging because the two is exact. I'm using that in the neutronium die. So I'll take I almost said plutonium. There's no plutonium here. Platinum.
Okay.
And I'll put all of these are now resolved. So that was pretty quick.
Very cool. One thing I don't know if you've been mentioning, when you do the rig roll, I like that. When you rig roll, you can only use that die once with one of the die on here. Like I can't use it twice. When you see we get more rigs die, you can't double use them.
Right.
So one use only. It's really important to remember that. All right, so that round is over. Let's do another one. So now we have a 3 and a 2. Okay. Assignment of our crew. So I'm going to, I'm going to use my captain. And I'm going to put the captain, where should I put the captain? I'm going to put the captain on a 3 and a 2. Let's go with the 6.
Okay. I'm going to go with export. I'm going to go on the export 3.
All right. And I'm going to go on the export 2.
Wow, 3 and a 2.
They're small numbers.
I'm gonna go for the cobalt. See if I can use that up.
And I'm gonna, for fun of it, I'm gonna do a +1 or -1 based on my roll a little bit later.
And I'm going to unlock some cargo.
All right.
Okay.
Okay, is everybody set there?
Yeah.
So roll the neutronium die. There comes up a 4 for that.
Comes up a 4.
And a bad guy.
The Marauders. Let's see. We've got gear sabotage again. Vortex drill and rover.
So nobody's on either one of those.
Nope, so we're safe.
Everybody's safe, which is good.
All right,
so then we're going, last but not least, we go ahead and resolve. I'm still leader. By the way, again, don't forget, Phil could steal leader if he wanted to, but
I could.
He hasn't done that yet.
Nope.
So my first thing is I'm going to go ahead and collect my 3 solar energies.
Very nice.
1, 2. Oh!
No, you did unlock one.
No, I didn't. That was our last game we played last night.
Oh, okay. That was last night.
I haven't. But wait. I should have done that first. Let's explain that really quick. Let me put that back. That's you.
That's me.
Oh, poo. All right.
Sorry. I got her confused because we played this last night.
So because I don't have enough cargo hold, I only have 3 open spaces, you can choose to get rid of one of your items. And obviously the yellow is worth more than the red, just so you know. So I'm going to put the neutronium back. And I'm going to go ahead and take all 3 yellow.
Yeah,
so that's the support. What I should have done, though, is I should have unlocked a cargo like Philip's doing. Fair enough. Now, let me roll my rig die because I forgot to do that. Okay, so it's a 4. Oh, look at that. I was looking for 6. So I got 4 plus the 2 is a 6. And because it's the captain, I get to take 2.
Yes, you do.
Orange. And I guess what? I can't do that because I have nowhere to put it.
By the way, I should note, the captain has another feature that he has when you put him on the asteroid.
He's no good now.
When I was using the rover before, I could have roved over if I was next to a normal character, but the captain blocks that. Yeah. I wouldn't have been able to rove over.
But wait, I just realized what I did wrong. So, I did get the 6.
Yes.
But, hold it. I have cargo to sell.
Yeah.
You can do these in any order you want, just so you know. So I'm going to go ahead and sell 2 cargo first. Wouldn't that be smart? So I'm going to sell the 2 solar solar energies, and those go back because those replenish as well. And that's going to be $6.
Right.
So 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Now I can resolve my 6 twice. So you have
The captain gets 2 of those.
Yeah, so I have to. You have to think a little bit about the order, which I wasn't doing just there, of how you want to play your crew. This didn't really make a decision. The precision imaging didn't do anything for me, so I'll just put that away. And now I think I am now resolved. But however, I have now reached $10.
Yeah.
Which means that I get to have 2 rigged die on my next turn.
Very nice.
Aha.
Okay. Nice. So
now you got to do yours.
I will roll my 1 lowly die over here, and I got a 4. With a 4 is the highest I can get. Doesn't get me to 10. I didn't do any gear, so I lose him. Okay. But I do get a Neutronium.
Yay!
And I have 1 spot left.
Booby prize.
Actually, I have 2 spots left, because with the cargo, it opens another spot.
Mm-hmm.
And then I'm also selling.
You're very patriotic over here on your card.
I said red, white, and blue.
Yeah.
And I managed to actually put myself on export 3, and now I have 3. So I'm going to export all these. So that's $1. That's, let's see,
six.
$6. And the I keep wanting to call it plutonium.
Plutonium, I know.
Platinum is 8. So
okay.
Those 2 go away. The neutronium comes back to the board. So let's see, that's 15 more. So let's see, that's 5, 10, 15.
So Phil jumps ahead, but he also has 2 die now.
I also unlock a die.
All right, very good, very good. All right, so continuing on, we'll do a couple more rounds, and then we'll, I think you're getting the gist of it. We just want to make sure you get a taste of it. All right, so let's do 1 more here. Okay, so we have a 4 and a 1. All right. And let's see, I'm going to assign, thinking of how I should assign. I am actually going to do the cargo hold.
That is smart.
With my captain, which means I can do it twice.
Mm-hmm.
So make sure I point that out.
These are lower numbers here, so I'm going to go for the 6.
Okay, I'm also going to do a 3 export.
Okay, and I'm going to do the 4.
Okay, and I'm going to do the 10. Oh, I'm picking up the guy I didn't earn yet. Oops. I'm going to do the 10.
You didn't hire him yet.
Yeah, I didn't hire him yet.
You know, I really want the 10, but I can't get there. I don't have enough guys. I guess I'll go with the 8.
Okay, and I'm going to go with... I want to do a... Which one was this one? I can't read. I'm getting old. Reboot.
Okay.
Which means I'm allowed to re-roll one of my rig die.
Mm-hmm.
I had to just remember to say which one I wanted to do.
Yeah.
All right, so we're done with the placement. We now roll the plutonium die, which is a 2.
Mm.
Bad guy.
Marauders.
Not my area.
Oh,
10, 12,
and 2.
So 10 gets affected, 12, no, and 2. It's just me.
Yeah.
So I could pay, or I could say, I'll let it go for now.
Hmm.
Oh, what the heck. I think I'll pay.
Pay an iron?
So I can keep. Yeah.
All right.
All right. All right, so that's resolved.
That's resolved, yes.
Mm-hmm. All right, so here we go. Time to resolve. So I got a 1. All right, but let me first start off by unlocking my cargo. And since I'm
smart.
Using the captain, I get 2 more spaces. So now I have 5 spaces to put cargo in,
mm-hmm.
just to be good. I rolled a 1. I am not going to meet the 10.
No
even
way.
Even after I paid for it. So that's not going to happen. And because I did not get any minerals, I get 1 neutronium.
Mm-hmm.
I could have re-rolled my rig die, though. I just thought about that.
Hmm. Give it a shot. Let's see what would have happened.
Yeah, it wouldn't happen.
Still wouldn't
anyway.
Have made it.
Still wouldn't have made it, so get him.
Yep.
And then I can still sell 3 minerals, so red, orange, and yellow. So I get a $3, $1, $4, and what was the orange? 8? So $8 total. $8 total. So that's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7. Oh, we're tied now. 8.
All right.
And I did that. And it's your turn.
Okay. Let's see. That's yours.
Okay. I was supposed to roll 2 rig die. Oh well, ignore that I forgot to roll my 2 rig die. No big deal.
Well, you did spend yourself. Oh no, you were still.
No,
tough,
I should have rolled 2
rig
die.
All right.
Forgot.
Well,
so we make mistakes. You guys know that.
Happens.
Yeah. But at least you find them. We did it. One of you guys
okay,
tells you.
Okay. Let's see. So with the 1 and the with the 6 and
mm-hmm.
the 2, I could get 8.
Okay.
So I'll get the 8.
Take the pink.
Take the pink. Now, what's left? I'm just going to put that back
Level
here.
1.
there's no way for me to get 4 or 6.
Mm-mm.
So they go away.
Yep.
And I don't get neutronium. And what else? That's it.
Let's do just 1 more,
mm-hmm.
just because I screwed up that last round. My 2 rig died. No big deal. We'll play 1 more just to show you 1 more feel of it,
yep.
and then we'll be done. All right, so let's go ahead and roll the power dice. We have a 3 and a 2. That's not that great, but all right. Let's see. I'm going to go to the, I'm going to go with the 4.
Okay. I'm going to go for the, that's pretty high. Well, I'm going to go for the 10.
Fine. I'm going to go with 6.
All right. I'm going to go for that rough imaging plus 3.
Okay. And I'm going to go ahead and sell my subcontractor for a dollar.
And I'm going to go with the vortex drill.
Okay.
Just more gear.
And just for fun, I'm putting my captain on the solar array. Because eventually, if I got it, I would get double, which would be kind of cool. All right, so roll our black die. Oh, what is with the low numbers?
Wow,
my goodness.
1.
All right, and bad guy.
Okay, let's see.
I can't
crew
see that
infiltration.
Oh, man, it's these.
Crew, yes.
Any of those. Well, guess what? I don't have any things to solve, so I have to take my guy off. I have to flee. I fleed.
Yep.
Okay, fair enough.
That's an option.
All right.
So that's done.
Yep, so now we resolve. Now I roll 2 rig die. And by the way, something to mention, if you have 2 rig die or 3 rig die, if you ever go backwards as you're paying for stuff, under the 20 or under the 10, you do lock back down the rig die.
Yeah, you lose them.
Yeah, that's important to know. So I'm going to roll. So now I have a 6 and a 5. Okay, so what I'm looking to resolve here is a 6. So obviously, there's a 1. Okay, so I'll use the 5 and the 1.
There you go.
To do my 6, and I get an orange. Okay. And this one I'm looking for a 4. Well,
You're already at 6, so
yeah,
that's not going to work.
That's not going to happen. So that's the end of that. So I don't get anything for that one. I'm going to move my soul array up 1, and I am done with my resolve.
I'll roll my 2. Okay, I got a 1 and a 6. Now this is interesting. Yeah. I gave myself a lot of options here. Yeah. So how can I get to 10? Let's see. With 7.
Without cheating.
With 7.
Plus a 3.
Plus the 3.
That's your 10.
I can get my 10.
All right.
Okay. So I'll grab that. There's nothing else here, so this gear does nothing. This vortex drill would have let me turn one of my dice upside down. So I could have got the 6 if I rolled a 1 and let's say a 3 or something else. I could have got there.
Yeah, these things are really cool. You got to just keep up.
Yeah, so you pretty much can cover every number if you really, really want to.
Yep. So you're done with your resolve.
That's it.
Okay. So and then we just keep doing it. Mm-hmm. You know, we get more dice potentially. All 3 minerals out of the 6 are emptied out. We finish whatever round we're on, play one more round, and then whoever has the most money wins. The funny part about the way we're ending this game right now is we're tied.
We're tied.
And I could just keep playing, but I know for our time for this, we like to make the show a little bit short.
Yeah.
We don't want to, spend the rest of the day playing, but we probably will finish this show up and play the rest of this one.
Yeah,
because I want to win. So anyway, guys, seriously, Darkrock Ventures. Really cool game. Looking forward to seeing the actual game itself. Love this. I don't even want to give back the prototype. I want to play it more.
Yeah, it's good.
So I highly recommend it. So if you look for it, again, Kickstarter, right? Darkrock Ventures.
Yeah,
that too. Can you tell? I'm a little hungry.
By Magic Meeple.
Magic Meeple Games and Gamelin Games. Thanks, guys, for watching again. We hope you support it. Talk to you soon.